Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about CTAD for NTTP. But before we do that, I do want to remind you about my upcoming C++ Best Practices class at NDC Tech Town in Kongsberg, Norway, in the beginning of September in 2024. If you are watching this episode and you are interested, be sure to check out the links in the video description. Okay, I know full well that this episode is going to take several definitions. Let's start with CTAD. This is the class template argument deduction. Now in C++, function templates have always had argument deduction. We didn't get this feature for classes until C++ 17. And it lets us do things like this. This vector v1 is a vector of type int. V2 is a vector of type float. These are two different types of objects. I let the compiler decide for me what they are. So if I try to assign v1 to v2, I'm going to get a plausibly confusing compile time error because they're actually two different types. And I have to go in and read in here and say, oh, that's a vector of int and that's a vector of double. Oh, okay. Now, traditionally, we would have written it like this, and then the problem becomes more obvious. Or if we didn't have our compiler warnings enabled, we might have done something like this and accidentally initialize a vector of ints with doubles and thrown away values. But anyhow, that is CTAD. A very useful place for it is with something like an array, where I want to automatically deduce that this is an array of three integers. I'm getting an unused warning here. Let's just go ahead and silence that warning for now. Okay, now the next thing is NTTP, non-type template parameters. So NTTP is something like, now this is a very meaningless function, but again, it's here to illustrate a point. I am explicitly instantiating a function called getValue that is a template function that takes an integer. This thing, that is the non-type template parameter. It's template parameters that are values. If I were to swap this around, then I'm expecting to actually explicitly say, I want you to return an integer to me. That is a type template parameter. Now, interestingly, we can do auto template parameters like this as of C++ 17, I believe. And as of C++ 20, I can constrain this template parameter and say, I want any integral value here. Okay, so what is CTAD with non-type template parameters? So I'm going to go ahead and see if we can use array like we were just using it. I've just done something kind of weird. I have said that this is a template function and its first parameter is an array. It is an array of any set of values, but they must be known at compile time. And then I am returning this value, the second value in it, which is the value 2 here. So this is the point. I can specify basically a template type for a template parameter. And I should be able to directly initialize this in the template instantiation in between the angle brackets. So I am saying, compiler, please deduce for me exactly what type of array I am passing to this function get value. And now you end up with some very interesting possibilities where you actually get values that are encoded in the type system. And it can make your symbol tables kind of big, but they take up no data. It's interesting. You can do lambdas, you can do all kinds of interesting things as non-type template parameters, also known as CNTTP, that is class non-type template parameters as well. I don't know what you're going to do with this information. I have used this in some real code, and there's definitely been episodes that have kind of accidentally mentioned this on the side. But let's go ahead and real quick actually disable optimizations so that we can see the generation of this getValue function. And we can see here, this is the name of the function. It is getValue with an awful lot of letters after it. Let's go ahead for our own interest, see if it's possible to actually demangle the name of this function. Take this encoded name and get back its... Nope, didn't find any symbols to demangle in the input. And in fact, we can see that Compiler Explorer is having a hard time with this as well. But encoded in that name is the name of the function and all the values in the array. And we can see that the name of the function in the compiled code actually got longer when I added more values to it. Well, anyhow, so that is CTAD, class template argument deduction, NTTP, which is the non-type template parameters, how these two things might go together, a hypothetically practical application for them, because now these are compile time constants inside of your function. That's kind of how you might pass const expr values to functions, and a little bit of behind the curtain look at what happens when the names of our functions get encoded. We call this mangling. Yeah, how all of these things might come together. I don't know. I hope you found this interesting at the very least. Perhaps you'll comment that C++ is too complicated, but I'll see you in the next episode.